I mean, I'm trying not to be fixated with this boy, but we need to plan, and we have 1 year to plan.
So we did the best guy we can find is important.
Performance first, not nationality or market.
Yeah.
Okay, if you look at top five, I mean, we want it strong already, right?
Mm. They all say very good things about this guy. But we need to decide this soon. We need to
me, that's the most difficult part. You know, who can we put as a second rider?
We are looking for something really great. You know, Frankie was the easiest one. He's the Moto2 champion. So we want someone is as exciting as Frankie. So when we ran out of ideas for existing MotoGP riders, we had to go down.
Ready for the start of this one. Quartararo on pole, Marquez second and Schrotter third. Away we go here for Moto2.
This man, though, has ridden the Grand Prix race of his life.
Take a bow! Good things come to those who wait. Fabio Quartararo finally gets his hands on a race win at Grand Prix level. Oh, that's a bit close, but he doesn't care. And it's a brilliant second place for Fabio Quartararo.
What a 2 weeks for Fabio Quartararo. Your race winner in Barcelona, a stunning charge from 10th to second place today in Assen.
When you produce two results like that on the spin, people take note.
We were at a loss. I mean, who do we take? We don't know. So Johan and me, we were sitting down in Assen. So we sat down and on the TV, and suddenly Fabio won the race on the speed up. You know, so Johan said, this guy. So I look, Quartararo. I thought he's Spanish, or I thought he's something else. I didn't know he was French. I didn't know who he was.
I know Fabio since he was participating in the FIM Junior World Championship.
Fabio Quartararo, a name and a face I'm sure we're going to be hearing and seeing a lot of over coming years. Twice a champion now then in the Moto3 ranks of the FIM CV Repsol.
And somebody who did what he do there, it is clear has the skills to do something like that.
Who will start from pole position? We've already seen so many times this year how quick this kid is. He was polling Jerez. Does he displace his teammate? Yes! A 39.484 from Quartararo.
What a force sector by the Frenchman. He dug deep there for that 39.4. He's over 2 tenths clear than a Maverick Vinales. El Diablo's got the job done.
Well, for good measure, he's throwing in another decent lap. Rasslin Rasly is just trying to work out if that's it.
11 days ago, he was on the operating table in Barcelona having arm pump surgery. Quartararo on course for pole position in Barcelona. There are more celebrations for Petronas Yamaha SRT. What a maiden season they are having, and what another performance by this young man.
Fabio, we need you to have breakfast with us. How are you?
Good.
Good? Yeah. Good sleep?
Tom?
Tom. A little bit open.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah?
Let me see. So, how are you feeling?
Good. Very good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Less stress on the arm, do you think?
Yeah, yeah, a lot.
On the...
Because yesterday, no, 2 days ago, in the night, when they take massage here,
Painful.
Painful.
Morning. Oh, really?
Yeah, because now the muscle can expand. Yeah. You know, before it was in there. Now, now look at look at the arm. It's like Popeye.
Does it stay?
Huh?
Does it stay like that?
Yeah,
because
compared to the other arm. Oh shit.
Yeah. For sure, it will go down a bit.
Yeah.
But it's massive.
was compressed. Yeah.
So every time you ride, they massage it.
Yeah, after warm up, I will do really light massage. Work a little bit the scar because you know it's not so good to push. And after the race, I will
take painkiller or stitches. You take a painkiller?
Yes, but nothing's really special, you know, yeah. Like Nurofen.
Yeah, I mean, the clinic I use.
Okay, good.
The seventh chapter of 2019 MotoGP World Championship is staged in Catalonia. The sun is out, the grandstands are packed. This is MotoGP. Quartararo then for the second time comes to the front of the grid in MotoGP. Both times he's done it have been on Spanish soil this year. He did it in Jerez, of course heartbreak from there when he had to retire from second place. Can Quartararo be the conservation master? Can he win for the first time? Can he be a first French Grand Prix winner in MotoGP since 1999? Blast off in Barcelona! Quartararo there trying to challenge now. Marc Marquez as we then head into turn number four. And what about Lorenzo? Look at Lorenzo!
Lorenzo! It's one to all now! How has this happened? They're all down, there's four of them.
Rossi's down! Rossi's down, Vinales is down! Quartararo, having got off to initially a bad start, is now, as a result of that incident, up into third place. He's on for a podium here, but he's got company. Alex Rins is hungry up just behind him. Danilo Petrucci then is now up into second place as Rins picks his way through on Fabio Quartararo. Morbidelli's gone down at turn number seven. Oh, Rins thought about it.
He's almost gone down!
Oh, dear me, how's he stayed up?
And in the meantime, Fabio Quartararo is now pouncing. He moves up into second. He uses the superior corner speed of his Yamaha. And Fabio Quartararo is on the podium for the first time, and that's magnificent for the 20-year-old from Nice.
It's easy to celebrate and run there to the podium, you know, and celebrate a second or a third place. But the difficult part is here when Franco arrives and his teammate is on the podium. So I need to be realistic and support him more at that point than Fabio, because Fabio is anyway at that point happy. And I think these are the moments where you can make the difference as a team to support the guys who are needed at most.
In Catalonia, we got our podium. I mean, we were going crazy. It's unbelievable. I mean, we were just lost for words.
Fucking nice.
Something that is beyond our expectations. We never expect a podium in Barcelona so soon. Of course, every round we feel that it's coming, but when, we don't know.
because you've done such an amazing job, and our title sponsors, Petronas, is really, really happy, you know. So I'm not sure whether it's early or not, but again, you know, why hide? So what we're going to do is that next year, okay, I'm not sure what's happening the rest of the year, but already Yamaha is really supporting more than what we have agreed this year,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Which is great, you know, but next year, both bikes will be the same. Okay, our contract says otherwise, but this year, for next year, we're going to have two factory bikes.
Four
factory bikes. Okay, so I think you deserve it.
Thank you very much.
Riding with our pump was a big issue. I was in the hospital thinking that maybe I couldn't make the Barcelona GP for this operation. And the first practice was really strange, feeling my arm so different than before. I still had the stitches on and was not easy the first practice, but as soon as I get used, I took a lot of confidence, make the pole position, first podium, and yeah, special moment because we came from a difficult week.
Grand ouverte, il y avait la lumière de... Pour ça que je suis rentré dans ta chambre. Je lui dis, mais il est parti où? Il dit, c'est pas possible, il est déjà levé. Ah. Pas très bon. Hein. Réduire moins le rapport final améliore la vitesse. Ah mais là, il faut que je mette plus. I met him 5 or 6 years ago. He was working on a, comment dire, aquatic, water sport center in France. So I went there for just make jet ski or was actually wakeboard. And until there, we always stay together from there, yes. If I'm alone, it's quite boring. So yeah, it's always cool to live with your best friend. So yes, alone I will be, yeah, sport, playing all the day on the PlayStation. So yeah, it's always nice.
Normally, I'm listening a lot rap music. I am the best at this, nah, you ain't gonna mess with this. Ever heard of what the veteran is? I work harder than most to be with the realists. Never stop training, cause I'm the best at this. I am the best at this, nah, you ain't gonna mess with this. Ever heard of what the veteran is? I work harder than most to be with the realists. Never stop training, cause I'm the best at this. The first
for the GP rider used to train a lot of cardio, is really important for holding like 40 minutes race, and also depends on which track we ride. We did a lot of triceps and upper body workout. Like you see, I have a bad stretching, so I need to work a lot on this. But yes, on the gym normally is arms workout and shoulders. You never rest when you are running, and for me it's most similar to be on the bike, so this is why I'm running a lot. If I'm suffering and when I'm running, it's because I want to win, I want to be fast on the track, and this is also my motivation to run.
Te encuentras bien, ¿no? Ya los puntos, la herida la tienes bien, ¿no? Y estirar los dedos con el codo extendido. Bueno, muy bien, ¿no? Lo tienes, no lo tienes duro como antes, ¿no? ¿Eh? Como siempre digo, primero cabeza y segundo gas, no al revés.
Claro. Ya lo haremos así. Barcelona lo hemos hecho así, entonces.
No, bueno, sí. Bueno, es que Barcelona es impresionante porque no solo hiciste podium, sino que hiciste la pole.
Pole también, podium.
Esto yo creo que en los pacientes que he operado yo, seguro que no, pero creo que no había pasado nunca.
¿No?
En mi opinión, yo creo que no había pasado nunca.
Gran trabajo.
No, el mérito es tuyo.
Los dos.
El mérito es tuyo, pero que hiciste pole.
Here comes El Diablo, Fabio Quartararo. The rising star, the rookie sensation, to the front of the grid for the second race in a row, his third pole position of the season, first French rider to take back-to-back poles in the Premier Class since Christian Sarron. Quartararo versus Marquez, and again a moment there on the power. Here comes Mark up the inside into the Rampton. That's far.
Beautiful.
Quartararo makes it back to back podiums, and that is great stuff from the rookie.
Independent team, 5 points behind Mr. Rossi, maybe 35 points from our target.
Bravo!
No, the target was between 50 and 100, eh?
Yeah.
We already fucking
67.
Il est plus beau que l'autre, tu l'as déjà.
Elle est tenue toute la course.
Daniele!
Fabio, the trophy is so much better. Important.
Achim! Thank you.
Okay, so you remember that?
Yeah, we remember. Okay. I know a little bit already the shape of the trophy.